morning children. Today we will discuss about nuclear size or nuclear radius. Before we are going into the class, just we will see some of the basics and what is anomalous scattering. We can say this one also as resonant scattering. So these type of scattering which we can observe when the frequency of the primary beam is close to the natural absorption frequency of some of the atoms in the structure. That means this anomalous scattering or resonance scattering, which occurs when the frequency of the primary beam is close to the natural absorption frequency of some of the atoms in the structure. Next one, Coulomb scattering, which we can also say as Rutherford scattering. Coulomb scattering, it is a elastic scattering of charged particles, scattering of the charged particles by the Coulomb interaction. This scattering occurs due to the Coulomb interaction. What are the lightest elements? We can say lightest elements are lightest chemical elements. We have hydrogen, helium, lithium, beryllium. These four are the lightest elements. If we consider hydrogen and helium, these are the gases. But if you see lithium and beryllium, these are the metals. But these four are the lightest elements. And the protons which are present in hydrogen, helium, lithium and beryllium are 1, 2, 3, respectively. That means hydrogen has one proton, helium has two protons, lithium has three protons and beryllium has four protons. And hydrogen has no neutrons. Hydrogen does not contain any neutrons. But helium, lithium, beryllium contains 2, 4, 5 neutrons. And these are about the lightest elements. And what is distance of closest approach? Distance of closest approach. Sometimes we can call as contact distance also. This distance of closest approach, or we can say contact distance. So this is the distance of closest approach which we can observe of the between the two objects. It is the distance between their centers when they are externally tangent. This is the distance between their centers when they are externally tangent. And what is muon? Muon, it is a Greek word. We can say it as mu, and this is classified as lepton. This muon, it is an elementary particle which is similar to the electron, and this have a charge of -1e and which has a spin half, but with much greater mass. So this muon has the much greater mass when compared with the electron. So now let us go with the presentation. So nuclear size or nuclear radius, already we have discussed about this Coulomb scattering or anomalous scattering or lightest elements, or about the distance of closest approach. Already we have discussed all the which are present and the tough terms in this nuclear size. Now in 19th century or in 1919, Rutherford found a deviation from the pure Coulomb scattering, anomalous scattering, which was observed. He observed the deviation of the pure Coulomb scattering or the anomalous scattering when alpha particles were scattered by the lightest elements. So when the alpha particles were scattered by the lightest elements, Rutherford found a deviation from the pure Coulomb scattering or anomalous scattering. So already we have discussed about the lightest elements. So in these light elements, the closest distance of the approach was the order of 5×10⁵ meters. So the distance of the closest approach at which anomalous scattering begins was the identified as the first measure of the nuclear radius. That means the distance of closest approach at which the anomalous scattering begins was the identified as the first measure of the nuclear radius. So we have an evidence from the experiments. The nucleus is composed of the protons and neutrons. The protons and neutrons combinedly called as nucleons. So the shape of the nucleus, it was taken as spherical. Why we have considered this shape of the nucleus is spherical? Because for a given volume of this shape, that means which we have considered the spherical shape. So for a given volume, which the shape that possesses the least surface area and which provides the maximum short range binding forces between the nucleons in the nucleus. That means volume which already we have given for this spherical shape, which provides the maximum short range binding forces between the nucleons. Nucleons are nothing but protons and neutrons. Short range binding forces between the nucleons in the nucleus. the small asymmetries of the distribution of negative charges present in some nuclei, as these nuclei exhibit high electric dipole moments. And here the small asymmetries of the distribution of negative charges present in some nuclei, as the nuclei exhibit high electric dipole moments. So if you consider most of the nuclei, the ellipticity is only of the order of 1%. So thus we may support that protons are uniformly distributed inside the spherical nucleus. So we have an experiment evidence that the nuclear density rho remains approximately constant over most of the nuclear volume. So then it decreases rapidly to the zero. That means from the experimental evidence, we have nuclear density which is represented with a rho, which remains constant, approximately constant over most of the nuclear volume. So and it decreases rapidly to the zero. So that means the nuclear volume is approximately proportional to the number of nucleons. That means nuclear volume is proportional to mass number A. So this is we can write this one as, so this is V, it is nuclear volume, which is proportional to A. Means here volume we have 4/3 pi r³, which is proportional to the number of nucleons. That means A. Or here R is, if we consider 4/3 pi, it is constant. That means nuclear radius R, which is proportional to the A power 1/3. R equals to R naught into A power 1/3. So here R naught, it is the nuclear unit radius. So here we have to find out the R naught, because we know the R value, and here 4/3 pi, it is a constant, and we know the mass number A, and we have to find out R naught value. So the method of measuring nuclear radius, it is divided mainly into the two categories. So first group, it is a method which is based on the study of the range of nuclear forces. That means by study of range of nuclear forces, so the nucleus is probed, the nucleus is examined by a nucleon or light nucleus. That means while we consider the study of range of the nuclear forces, then the nucleus is examined by a nucleon, or nucleon means which is a proton or neutron, or any light nucleus. And the second category, second method to find out the radius of the nucleus, it is the studies, the method is the electric field and the charge distribution of the nucleus. The nucleus is examined by the electron or muon. Already we have discussed about muon. That means we have, we can find out the nuclear radius by these two methods. That means by examining the nucleon or light nucleus, we can find out the, in the case of first method, or by examining the electron or muon, in the second method, we can find out the size of the nucleus. So this is about size of the nucleus. Thank you, children.